Hello, everybody. We are currently sitting inside because we're no longer in sunny, beautiful Miami, Florida, unfortunately. But we're going to go through the top five things that we learned in Florida while at the Asian 2021 conference hosted by Gary Vaynerchuk. We're going to see clips from him during his keynote. We're going to see some clips during him during some one-on-one conversations at the VIP dinner. It's a lot of good stuff, and I hope you guys learned something, so stay tuned.
It's always about distribution. Amazon's the biggest company in the world because they were the best at Google AdWords in the early 2000s. Right now, that is social media. The content is the variable of success.
Right.
You're here, you're at this event. What comes out of my mouth right now is a variable of how you will remember or value this event. The content, the attention to get someone to the place that you're paying attention. If I give the greatest keynote of all time in my bathroom tonight with nobody there, but if I give a shit one tomorrow, similar kind of thing. So these things are unbelievably tight.
So as Gary says, distribution and content are two very important things as far as getting in front of your consumer and creating a brand. For example, with content, let's see how this metaphor holds up. If I want to be a good friend, I will get Frankie a cup of coffee because he asked me to. But if I pour that coffee down the drain, it means nothing. I need to give him the coffee and distribute. This is a kindergarten lesson on content. That's how you provide the value. You actually have to distribute it. On to the next clip.
Do you think it's better off editing and putting out less content?
No. I decided to write a book called Volume.
Oh, what?
Volume.
So just put it out.
Yep.
Good, bad, or indifferent.
Because guess what? Not putting it out has no fucking shelf.
The moral of the story there is, what's the worst that could happen? Your options are to either overthink and not put something out because you don't think it's perfect, or to just put it out anyway and hope for the best. And if you're not going to put it out, there's no way you get anything from it. What? It doesn't have to be perfect, Frankie. We literally just went over how it doesn't have to be perfect. Do not correct my ums every time I say Next clip.
There's an enormous amount of passion I have for people to get excited about producing a lot more content. The sheer volume of content that I think will be the differentiator of the mature understanding of this social and digital web is gonna be the differentiator. You're not gonna be able to continue to just beat your competitors by knowing to run Facebook ads. People will catch up over the next 2 or 3 years. So I'm already starting with the thesis that's gonna help you compete, which is your ability to somehow figure out how to make 500 or 1,000 pieces a month instead of 3.
This one you can take from me of all people. You're not gonna put out one Instagram ad and then all of a sudden make your money back because your leads are gonna get converted that quickly. The more you put out and the more you continue to give and get yourself in front of the end consumer, the more things are gonna happen for you. You throw as much as you can at the wall until something sticks. Volume is the only way that you're gonna differentiate yourself when everybody is now putting out all this crap on social media, because it is that cheap. So next clip.
It comes down to value. If I sell real estate in fucking hardcore Texas, where the religion of our shit town is fucking high school football.
You know my future daughter.
High school football.
Yeah.
I would put out high school fucking football. More human. Right? If I lived in a town where the pothole on Main Street hasn't been fixed for 9 months and everybody's talking about it, and I go and fill it in the middle of the night by folding it and filling it myself and then running it to everybody in town, I'm going to sell a lot of homes.
So what do these three things have in common, right? You got Tony Robbins, you got subtle art of not giving a bad word, and you got Jerry talking about 401ks and financial planning. They all provide you value. It's not enough to just push out a bunch of nonsensical content hoping that, like, for some reason someone's gonna, you posted this many things, now you're okay, you're good. No, like, you have to provide value to the end consumer. That's how you're gonna differentiate yourself from somebody who's just trying to make it by pumping out a bunch of crap and just trying to stay in front of people by posting pictures of them on the beach because they're making money. It's not gonna work. Next clip.
It all comes down to sales and branding. There's a very simple question this room. Are you in the sales business or are you in the brand business? Everybody in this room is in the sales fucking business. I'm trying to get everybody in this room to add some level of brand. Because when shit hits the fan, the reason this industry always gets fucked the most is because you're short-term whores to sales.
Yes.
The more you can actually build brand by bringing value to the end consumer, that is the leverage point in the end, always in the end, always in the end.
So, there's sales and then there's branding. The sales is what's gonna give you the short-term metrics like immediate revenue and results and all that good stuff that your boss is probably excited about. But when the shit hits the fan, like Gary said, what's gonna be left, it's just gonna be the brand. So for us, not only do we have these dope hats that you can only pretty much wear on a golf course, but we started doing this vlog, which you're watching literally right now. We upped our social media presence. We started putting out paid ads on Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. Oh, we're redoing our website. We're redoing our logo. We're getting our brand to where we want it to be. We're revamping our company culture. We're taking slow steps to get our brand where we want it to be, because when everything hits the fan, your brand is all you have. And that's what's gonna bring in the long term, that's what's gonna bring you those short-term metrics like sales. Thank you guys for watching episode 30 of Full Coverage. I hope you learned a lot from Gary V and myself. And I just wanted to give you a heads up that this season we're gonna be releasing a ton of content. Look forward to a ton more interviews, a lot more vlogging, and a lot more fun and education on the wonderful topic of insurance. So I'll see you guys next week. We're gonna be interviewing a girl that actually used to work for Gary V and is now a food blogger. She's really killing it. Her name is Carbs Cassidy. I went to high school with her. We're gonna be catching up with her. So stay tuned and check that out next Friday on Full Coverage, episode 31. Bye.